Hello everyone. Today let us know about the project Foodbyte. So first let us extract the zipped file, and we can see that there are three zipped files: source code, database backup and project document. Let's extract the three files again. So you can see the file is extracting, and you can see the source code folder is created and data backup folder is created. And let's now extract the project document, and the folder is created and the file is extracting. So now the files are extracted, and you can see the folders. The source code contains all the PHP codes. The database backup contains the SQL file, that is the database. And in project documents, all the documents related to the project Foodbyte is available. Now let us copy the source code folder. And let's paste this in local disk C, that is under XAMPP folder in htdocs. This is because I have installed the XAMPP control panel in C drive. Wherever you have installed, you can paste it there. Now open XAMPP control panel and start Apache and MySQL server, and we can see that the two servers are running. And now copy the name of the source code and open the browser. In the browser, type localhost slash and paste the name of the source code. This is how we will execute our project, and we can see the website now, but we can see there is some unknown MySQL error. That is because we have not imported the database. So to import the database, type localhost phpMyAdmin, and you can see the MySQL database. In databases, create the database name. Remember, the database name must be same as the database backup file what you have, that is a SQL file. So once the database is created, click on import and go to the database backup file by clicking on choose file. And in database backup file, you have a SQL file Foodbyte, and click on open and it will be uploaded, and click on go to upload it to the database. So it is imported successfully, and we can see that the database Foodbyte has got 10 tables. Now go to the website and click on refresh, and you can see the updated website. Now let us select the location. We can see the website Foodbyte. The main objective of developing this project, that is Foodbyte, is to order various foods and beverages from some local restaurants and hotels through online. Here the customer can order the food from different restaurants present in that particular location. It can be a veg restaurant, non-veg restaurant, or the restaurant in which both veg and non-veg food is available. Here the customers can order food items just by sitting at their home or by sitting at any place. Now let us log in as admin under employee login panel. So the admin can log in by using the admin ID and the password. So here the default admin ID and password is admin itself. So the admin is logged in successfully, and the admin dashboard is available. So we can see the various options for the admin. And in employee panel under add employee, here the admin can add the employees. The admin can add the employees by mentioning the admin name, the type, the location of the employee, the login ID and the password of the employee. The confirm password of the employee must be mentioned, and the employee type must be chosen, whether it is admin or employee must be selected. On clicking on submit, the admin record will be inserted. Under view employee, the admin can view the various employees along with the action edit and delete. In add location, admin can at the various locations in which the delivery option is available, and to add locations, the location name, description, and the status must be selected. Once the employee record is added, it can be viewed under view location, and here the various locations can be viewed. In add city, the cities can be added by selecting the particular location. So I'm selecting each location, the cities for that location can be added. So to add the cities, the location must be selected, then the city name and the description and the status must be selected. And on clicking on submit, the city record will be inserted successfully, and this can be viewed under view city. So under view city, along with the location name, the different cities can be viewed. Under restaurant, in add restaurant, here the admin can add the various restaurant details. That is by mentioning the restaurant name, login ID, password, confirm password, the location and the type of the restaurant, and the restaurant image must be selected by the admin, and the description about the restaurant must be mentioned. On selecting the restaurant status and clicking on submit, the restaurant record will be inserted, and this can be viewed under view restaurant. So the various restaurants that are available in the website can be viewed here by the admin. Under category, in add category, the various categories can be added. While adding the category name must be mentioned, the description about the category must be given, and then the category image is chosen. The status must be selected, and on clicking on submit, the category will be added, and which can be viewed under view category. So here the various categories can be viewed by the admin, and he can also edit and delete the category details. In item, under add item, the admin can add the item by selecting the particular restaurant. Then the category of the item must be selected, and the type of the food, whether it is general or a breakfast, lunch or dinner, that must be selected, and the name of the item must be mentioned, and what is the cost of that particular item must be mentioned. And the image of the item must be added. And the item description must be mentioned, and the type of the item, whether it is a veg food or a non-veg food, must be mentioned. And once the item is inserted, it can be viewed under view item. And here the admin can delete or edit the item details. Under offer, in add offer, here the admin can fix an offer details for the food that is provided by their website. So here the offer type must be mentioned, the offer title must be mentioned, offer code, the start date, that is the start date of the offer, and the end date of the offer must be mentioned. Once the offer record is inserted, this can be viewed under View Offer. So here the admin has the action Edit and Delete. Now let us see report. In report under food order payment report, here the various food orders done by various other customers can be viewed with the, all the particular details. And in standard food order report, here the standard food orders can be viewed with the actions, that is whether it is under process or whether it is delivered. And in daily food order report, here the daily orders of the particular customers can be viewed. Under customer report, the various customer details can be viewed along with the address details, location and city. And in login report, whoever logins to the website, their recent login date and time must be viewed by the admin. So the admin monitors the entire thing here. So let us log out from admin. Now let us register as customer. The customer can register by mentioning the customer name, the email ID, password, confirm password, and the contact number of the customer must be mentioned. On clicking on click here to register, the customers will be registered successfully and they can log in by using the email ID and the password. So once the customer logs in, under my account, here the customer can update their profile under my profile option, and here the customer can give their company name, address, location and city details. And in my account, in change password, here the customer can make changes to their password. To make changes to their password, they must mention their email ID and submit, and they'll get a link to change their password. So in my orders, they can view all the orders done by them, and they can view the delivery status of the order. In regular orders, they can view the regular orders, and in daily orders, they can make the daily orders. Here they must select whether vegetarian or non-vegetarian food, and on that they must select the hotel name, and there is an option add to daily order cart. So on adding it to the cart, they can make an order here. We'll check about by selecting the particular hotel. So let us click on one of the hotel here. Under veg, we are selecting, we can view the hotel details, and let us click on a hotel and view about that hotel, and we can view the foods available in that hotel. And click here to order. We'll add your food to the cart. So we have added two food items to the cart, and we can see that cart is updated to two items, and we can see the cost of that item. Confirm order, and your order will be confirmed, and you can make the payment method here. So to make the payment, we must type payment type and the card holder name, the card number, expiry date must be selected, and then the delivery address of the customer must be mentioned. The city must be selected, and the delivery date and the time must be mentioned. So let us give the time and the date. So on clicking on make payment, the payment will be made, but we can see that we have not filled some data here. And let's check that we have not filled CVV number. On filling the CVV number, clicking on make payment, the payment will be made successfully. And now we can see the payment received, where the order status is ordered, and we can see the payment date and the delivery date and time can be viewed here. Now let's log out from the customer and let's log in as the admin. So let us select the location and let us log in as the admin. Once the admin logs in, the admin dashboard is available. And under report in food order payment report in standard order, we can view the various orders made by different customers here. And in standard food order report, we can see the latest order what we have got from the different customers, and we can see the two orders which we made by us, and clicking on process, the food status will be updated. And now we can see that there is an option to pack, and let us do the same for the next order also. Click on process and the food order status is updated now, and it is updated to pack. And now we can see that on clicking on pack, the order will be packed. And let's do the same thing for the second order also, and we can see that both the orders are packed now. Now let us log out from admin and let us log in as the customer again. So the customer must log in using the customer email ID, and the password of the customer must be mentioned to log into his account. Once the customer has logged in, under my account, in my orders, he can view the food orders, and on clicking on view, the payment receipt can be viewed and where the status can be viewed as a packed. So now let's log out from the customer. So this is about the project Foodbyte. Thank you for watching the video. For further queries, kindly visit our website. Thank you.